Welcome to Trading Lounge and the Australian Report for Tuesday, September the 21st, the full moon. Not that that means a great deal, but in the old days and still today, the accounting was done around those natural cycles. So that's sort of how they work and play into the markets to a bit point. The weekly chart for the ASX 200. We've got wave 1, 2 and 3 up here. Wave 4 would pull us back to, well, the wave 4 of one lesser degree, which would be down at 6,600 or roughly just 6,900. So we could say, you know, we're looking at the 7,000 here for wave 4. The tricky thing is that out of the 12 corrections that there are in Elliott, roughly 11, 12, wave 4 can accommodate all of them. So normally we would be looking for the first leg down, which would be the A wave, the B wave and the C wave here. If we had a normal 5 waves down, it makes life really easy for the A wave, because then we just get a B wave and then we get another 5 waves down. But the first move down through here has been a bit awkward, so we don't have a clear 5 waves. It's more likely to be in 3 waves, and then we'll look for an ABC and then another 5 waves down. It can get a bit more complicated than that as well, but the takeaway is that we're in wave 4. We can pull down to the 7,000. It's not going to be easy. Some parts are going to be very difficult and they're going to be a bit of a guessing game, and I'll get them wrong and I'll get some right. So if you're in this game, then you need to trade less to the downside. On the daily chart, we can look at it like this, as an A wave, a B wave, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 down through here. That's a bit loose, but we'll get into that in a moment. Now, the problem with this is, I mean, it looks okay-ish. The problem with this is that most of our correction started early. So most of the other markets around the world, we'll say the big ones, they're still coming down for their A wave, and then they're going to go back up for the B wave and down for the C wave. So we probably have to do that as well. We will probably have to, because we'll be pulled around with them most likely. So we will probably have to put this over here and that over there, and remove the A wave from here, the B wave from here that we're talking about. And this 5 wave structure can come in over here and put that there for wave 5 of C of 4, and we'll look at the A wave here, the B wave back up here, and so we need to look at, let's put in a little A wave there, or just drop that down into a reasonable size, the B wave. So as I mentioned when we started all this, it's a little bit of a guessing game how it sort of plays out. So we can look at the A wave here, the B wave up here, and the C wave down to here. So from the B wave to the C wave, we'll be looking for 5 waves. So we've got 1 and 2 here. So I'm thinking, in line with the US, we need to also approve this yet, is wave 4 and 5 here. And then we'll have an ABC up to supply zone here. And then we'll have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 down here for these guys over here. So we can start to put Humpty Dumpty together again, join all the dots over here. And so it's kind of looking a little bit like this at the moment. Don't need that. And this B wave will be 3 waves up there as well. So that's kind of how it's looking at the moment. But we need to sort of, you know, continue to work on this particular count. We are short at the moment. The A wave here, the B wave here. It's possible to have the ABC here for this, and then we can go up from this point. So that's also a bit of a thing. So I'm just going to move these out of the way here a little bit. So that could be the low there. But otherwise, if I can just borrow these, or do I have some over here? Yes, good. I'll put wave 3. So we just really need to monitor this little wave 4 here. And this is on the same on the US markets as well. So will we get this other little move down through here, because the US markets appear to be coming down in five waves, but we need to confirm that. And if that's the case, then we're going to get the B wave and then down for the C wave. So we're likely to go with them in that case. So in this instance here, we can take the top here. We can tune this later down here. So that will be the 38.2% retracement level there. We'll just move that on top there and move that. So this will be the A wave, a B wave, and a C wave here. And hopefully we'll get this five waves down to the 7,000, and then we'll get the A, the B, and the C back up to supply zones, all the 50, 60% retracement level. And we can use those then in that regard. I'll just put that there. Just make them small. It's a little bit more refined in that way, not so clumsy. But it's all just opinions. Let's just copy that, this. So we're starting to get there, you know. This, where's that little guy here? Copy that. Put that over there. We'll look at the 50, 60% retracement level from here. We'll just take it to 7,000. We can adjust things a little bit later. That's here to here. So that's all good. So that's kind of what we're looking at so far, but it could get out of hand a bit more. We're not quite sure just yet how this will play out. But so what we're looking for next, this move down through here, we basically want to take profit on that here. Okay, so just do that there on that. I didn't trade this one down. I had a little bit of pocket money on the S&P. An A and a B and a C for this. This is what we need to be mindful of. This, you know, this move up through here can just continue to move up through there. So let's just have a look at the 1 hour chart, if I've updated at all. I haven't. Yeah, well, I have and I haven't. So here we can look at a little A wave. Get the right size, a B and a C wave. So what we're going to do is we've got a few trades in here, so that's all gone well. I suggest that we take the money off the table here. We're going to be looking for an A wave, a B wave, and a C wave. And the reason we're taking the money off the table is not so much of this is because I don't know if we're going to get that. We could get wave A here that's going to take us much higher. Do you know what I mean? So I don't know if we're going to get wave five down here just yet. So that's what I'm hoping we will. So we just need to monitor this move, this rally here, because it could go higher. That's the point. So I'll put that wave A here as well, just so you understand what's at stake. So it is possible that wave A is in here. Probably not. And if I can figure this out tomorrow, then we'll short this down here and then we can go long through this again up through here. But we'll take that money. Thank you very much. And we'll be happy. Okay, so that's that. Let's check out the banks. So the Commonwealth Bank, I'm thinking that we still need, this to me is reminds me of being corrective, like it's a corrective rally because it's got overlapping wave structures. So we're looking at this to move down further here and then have a B wave here. I'm still also guessing, too many objects on the chart. So yeah, and then down again from that point. So that's what I'm thinking here. On the tick chart, we looked at going short yesterday. Just keep the stop above that. Okay, and we'll follow that up later. We'll look to add to a position under here, but this is, you can see how it's really sticky here, so we have to be careful. You know, we're in a corrective pattern across that trading level one, that major level, and it's just going to be, it's not going to be very trendy, you know. Just the ANZ here. So we're looking at the same here again. So the good thing about here now is that we're waiting for that little breach below here. So we could look at this as being wave five, because we could look at this as wave one and two here, then one, two, three, four, five. So that could have been wave four sitting on there as the E wave here for a long triangle pattern across here. But we've got that other move down. So now we've got five waves that can come down further, but then we're going to get the B and the C. So we'll allow that to come down. We'll wait for the B and then we'll short the C wave down and then we'll go buying down here as well for that. So that's what we'll do with this market. And that takes us over to, let's just have a look at India first. So with India, we were looking at calling the top of wave three and to either take a percentage or take profit on that trade. The wave four will be back at the 17,200. So that's all sort of playing out nicely. We'll get one more push up to the 18,000. I do suggest taking profit there. It can go higher and all the rest of it. The extension was in wave three, so wave one and wave five can be roughly the same. Bit of a rule of thumb. Don't take it accurately though. Just gives you a bit of a guide stick. But 18's a big number, and there will, I call it a profit-taking number, and it will, you know, you will see the bids be hit there. And if it goes a little bit higher, it's only going to come back here again anyway. So that's that. China, let me just have a, first of all, let's have a look at China here. And then I want to have a look at China on the comp. Okay, so we don't have, we know we got five waves here on the comp, and then we got the correction, and then we can look at this as it hasn't overlapped. What's that? Oh, that's Friday's bar. Where's Monday? Monday should be here. Maybe I haven't updated it. Anyway, hopefully it hasn't overlapped this one yet. Although not that that matters really, because it could be one and two and one and two. Yeah, it hasn't collapsed yet anyway. And the A50 is a completely different story than their local markets, because it's really just about, you know, the, you know, Alibaba and whatnot, all that on the New York desk. So anyway, we'll see how that goes. We're looking for five up and we're looking for three back. We got that. If it takes the low out here, I'll need to readjust the account here for this and look lower. So over to the resources, iron ore. Didn't that also update yesterday? So was there a holiday? Was there a holiday in China? Okay. Must be something going on that I've missed. Okay. Well, anyway, that still has further to go down iron ore. So we might as well just go straight to, well, we'll have a look at crude. So we will look, it looks like crude's falling over here. We were looking for one more little move to the upside here, but just keep an eye on our charts for that. So we're still in that B wave and still looking for a C wave to come down for that. Clean things up. I need more space. I'll leave that there. That's important. Don't need that. Let's have a look at copper. So we don't need that. Don't need that. I don't need these guys here for that. Don't need that. So we're looking for five waves down for wave four here. So we've got the B wave in play. The A, the B, and the C for the B wave, one and two and three and four and five here to finish this off. So the third wave looks like it's done. We'll see a fourth wave come back to the wave four of one lesser degree at that point and then move down through here. So we're going to see where all the wave, the fours and fives play out across the medium level here for that. I want to keep those. That's all good. Let's go to the daily chart for a moment to have a look at this in the bigger picture. So we're looking for, don't need that. So yeah, all of the A wave here, the B wave here, and the C wave to come down. Hopefully we'll get nice five waves to finish that off, and it doesn't get more complicated than that. So we'll just see how that plays out. I did miss gold, so I'll just go back to gold here for a moment. So yesterday, I won't go into a big deal here, but yesterday we're looking at wave three, four, and I think we're in here somewhere. We're looking for one more low to come in just below here. So we've got that, and then we're looking for a impulse wave to the upside. So I was counting this. I will double check it, but one and two here, one and two and three and four and five for the third, fourth, fifth for the wave one here, the A wave, the B wave, and the C wave to come back. So we're basically entering into, we're leaving the midpoint, entering into group two. So group two is 65, 17, 65, 65, 72, and 80. There's other important numbers in here as well, but that's just the skeleton. So what we're looking at here, I didn't quite get this. It does appear that we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here. I have to check that. 1 and 1 here, 2. So 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 5. Could be, it looks like 5 waves here, and then the A wave, the B wave, an A and a B, and the C wave here. As a C wave here, it looks like we want one more with 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 here. So that B wave can be up here. So we'll have to wait for that B wave to come in before we go along. We want that top there because we still need the C wave. The other point here that I was looking at is that we could already have 5 waves up for the B wave here already, which will be a C wave, an A, B, yeah, I need to go that way, an A and a B and a C, because we could look at this as 1 and 2 here. And then I was thinking in here of 1, 2, 3, well, where are we? All of this for the third wave anyway, the fourth wave and the fifth wave here. Bit of a long shot. So I'm not sure how that's going to resolve yet. I just need to sort of ponder that. But the good news, the takeaway here, whichever way you want to look at it, is we're going up, because we've got 5 waves in this structure here. That's pretty clear to me. I just need to resolve that a little bit here. So you could say tested support on 1765 would create the long trade at that point. Silver, however, still got a little way to move down. So just having a quick look at silver here, from wave 4 down to wave 5 here, we were looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for 1 and 2, and then 1 and 2, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for the third wave. Fourth wave still needs to play a little bit further for 4th, down for the 5th and 4th and 5th. So a little bit more to go with this. So if you're still short, just hang in there for a while. That can pull back to the wave 4 of 1 unless it agree. Probably wouldn't hurt to take a bit of money off the table there. And then that wave 3 can be there, that wave 4 will be over there, and wave 5 will probably be a little bit lower. So it'll probably reluctantly move lower if gold's going to push higher. And what else do we need to look in here? So we need to have a look at the dollars. So the Australian dollar, this is just on the daily chart here for this. So basically we're looking for an A and a B and a C wave down here, okay? So counting this as 5 waves up here, I just thought it was a little bit too marked because it counted better as an ABC. If that's the case, then we have to look at that as a wave 4 and then down for a wave 5 here. But otherwise, we'll need to stay with the A, the B, and C. So I'm going to stay with the A, B, and C while the 72 is the support, which is roughly the 78.6 retracement level, square root of 61.8%. So as long as that stays in place, the market can spike through there, but it needs to develop support on this. I'm going to give it a bit of space because we're still trying to figure out what's going on with the US dollar index. So on the 4-hour chart, we've got wave 4 up here. We know that the whole shebambles is corrective in that regard. This whole correction here from the low here, because this first leg is corrective. So it makes all of this corrective. So I've just gone for the simple A, B, and C here for wave 4. It can move up to the wave 4 of 1 lesser degree, which is over here. So that's also, on the cards as well. But we could count 5 waves down here. The wave 3 in the middle is a little bit short, so somehow. But anyway, 5 waves, we could work with that. And then if that's the case, then we're looking for an ABC. So we're looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for the A wave, the B wave that we've been working on. And then from wave B to wave C here, we're working on this little move in through here. So we'll go from the 4-hour to 15 minutes and we'll check in on that. So so we've got the A wave here. As I mentioned, the B wave pull back to 61.8%. This is not a very nice 5 waves up here, but I've got it as 1 and back for 2 here. But we may end up just bringing the B wave over here and being here, and we can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We can have a top in place right now. If we don't do that and we put the B wave back over here, then we'll have to look at this as 1 and 2, and all of this is the third wave up here, coming back for the fourth and then going up for the fifth of the C of 2 over here somewhere. So we're basically you know, splitting hairs here with all of this. So this move here, being a wave four here, it can pull back, if we look at that in terms of this low, it can pull back 38.2%, which is basically where it is. So it'll be interesting to see how this plays out, because it looks like one and two and three here, this looks corrective as wave four and dropping down for wave five. So will that give us an A wave, a B wave, and a C wave for wave four? Or will this be wave one here, back for wave two, and then start coming down for wave three? I just don't know. We just still got to wait for all this to play out a little bit further, unfortunately. But that will be that. So yeah, that wave four could even be over here with an A and a B. Let's just see how this plays out first. And we'll have to wait for the five waves to come down, three to come back. And if it moves down, you know, swiftly, then we'll know that we've got a top in. But otherwise, we'll still have to wait. I mean, the commodity prices are still being hammered. So with, I'm just going to do BHP. So just go to the Australian BHP. So just going back over the whole situation, so we're on the same page. We can have wave five top here, and we can have an ABC for a correction, and then we can have wave one and two and one and two, and then go up into a very powerful, you know, third of a third wave up that way. The other side of this, though, is that all of this move down from the top here can be the A wave here, an ABC here for an expanded flat as a B wave, and then down for the C wave here. And if it's an expanded flat taking out the top here, then we're going to come down and take out the wave A low here. So we're going to end up down at $10 to $13 down here for wave C. Now, you may say that's impossible, but I don't think anything is too high or anything is too low. And the world is a bit shaky out there, as you know. Everybody's getting their toys together to give each other a hard time. So we just don't know what's going to happen with all of this. Wave twos are normally sharp in that regard. So coming into the weekly chart, we would need to look at it like this. We've been counting five waves down. So we'll count this here as one and two and three and four and five for one, an A wave here, across for a B wave and down for a C wave. Now, I can work with that, but the A wave has come down to the 61.8%, so it does make it kind of bearish in that case. But, you know, we're going to have our five waves down, which are going to finish shortly, and we're going to have some sort of rally. So it's either going to be wave B rally or it's going to be wave two. And then we'll won't know the bigger picture until wave C starts. And it really sort of depends on, you know, how wave C is. You know, is it going to be on more of an angle than wave A? Wave A is normally sharp and frightening and scary, and that's what it's doing, you know. But we will just track, we'll go through those motions, and we'll go through this motion here of wave C, but you'll need to be mindful that don't make any big moves until we, you know, got things sorted out a little bit, because it could certainly come down a lot lower at that point. Do you know what I mean? So, yeah, it's unfortunately the way the cookie has crumbled. Alrighty, I'm just going to leave it at that. Yeah, alrighty, cheers.